All right, man, let's talk about Jared Goff. Now, Jared Goff says that his contract extension talks have not started yet. So, yeah, he said they have not started talking about contract yet. And, I mean, obviously, you know, historically the Lions wait to the last minute to do stuff. And, you know, but it says they haven't addressed the, an extension just yet. And at the end of the day, you know, they said they've been in the market for a younger quarterback to develop and grow. So Jared Goff addresses contract extension talks with the Lions. Since quarterback Jared Goff admitted during a news conference that he has yet to enter contract extension negotiation with the Detroit Lions. He said, I mean, of course you'd be open, Goff told reporters as he as shared by Justin Rogers of Detroit News. It hasn't been brought to my attention, but yeah, of course I'm open to anything, not up to me. I'm a player. I don't have to make those decisions. And if I did, I'd have made the decision a long time ago. Give me and all my friends all money in the world, but I just get to play. And if that comes about, that'd be great, but we'll see. Okay. Goff is signed through 2024 campaign and it's coming off a better, the better of his 2 years with the Lions, according to ESPN stats. The 28-year-old ended this past season ranked fifth among qualified quarterbacks with a 61.1 adjusted QBR, top of fifth in touchdown with 29 touchdown passes and six with 4,438 yards in the air. He just tossed seven interceptions across seven games. The Lions seems he ruled out the move for Baltimore quarterback Lamar Jackson. He's on a non-exclusive tag, but Detroit head coach Dan Campbell indicated late March this club could draft a young signal caller with the sixth pick or the 18th. I think it's more posturing. He said, we have had good talks more towards the end of the season, right after last season, Goff said, about conversations he had with general manager Brad Holmes. Everything had been clear and open. I got all the trust in the world in Brad and Dan and everything they do. I'm really excited to see what we do and where we go. If Goff guides the Lions to a playoff guard and post similar numbers to the ones he produced in 2022, Troy likely would have locked him down via an extension that would benefit both parties before he celebrates his 30th birthday in October 24th. And I agree. If he does great next year, I mean, he had one bad year, one good year. The bad thing about the bad year is exactly what I said when he got here. What did I say for people who remember? I said that you have to surround Jared. The number one thing is surrounding Jared Goff with offensive talent. Forget defense and all the rest of the stuff. This guy needs to be surrounded with premier talent. That's the thing I said. And guess what? They didn't do that, and he suffered. They got some talent around him. He prospered. As simple as that. Football decisions ain't that hard. I don't know, you know, what Brad Holmes was looking at. Were they trying to tank on purpose or whatever? I don't know. But they sabotaged them. They sabotaged them the first year. Didn't give them no weapons or nothing. So, you know, he have another good year like this next year. Him, Jameson Williams, James Mitchell, St. Brown, whoever else they got in there, Dave Montgomery, etc. Then, yeah, I think you feel like you got to pay him. Now, I'm not paying him record-breaking money and no shit like that, no matter how good he is. But I think he deserves a good, you know, payday. But you look at what Daniel Jones got, and you hear people saying, we paid for Lamar, we got to pay him. You draft a quarterback, you got to pay. You got to pay Jared Goff regardless. Don't matter. You're going to have to end up paying for a quality product regardless. That's just what it is. And you hear the same fans talking about money and paying people, but it's the same fan base that say Alliance don't ever spend no money. You know what I'm saying? Stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? So that's the crazy thing about it. That's the crazy, the whole crazy thing about it, man, is that you know, fans want to have it both ways. Well, you don't spend no money. Oh, don't spend that money. Like, man, shut the fuck up. Excuse my language. Sound like Uncle Rookish. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, y'all just not happy regardless. You got to pay somebody. Me personally, they take a quarterback or they trade for a quarterback, Goff going to have the best year of his life. They don't take a quarterback, Goff going to shit the bed. That's just usually how it go. You know? So, I mean, if you see a good thing and you like it, take it. You always can, you know, showcase it, showcase that talent in preseason, worst case scenario, and trade them. Look at Trey Lance. He got a gang of suitors already. He got a gang of suitors. A gang of them. So, to me, it makes a tremendous amount of sense, you know what I'm saying, to lock that position up. And if Goff go out there and do something incredible, then you got to, that's a good decision you got to make. You know, San Francisco handed the keys over to Trey Lance last year. That's what they believe. We don't know how it would have turned out, but then again, Jimmy Garoppolo got injured, and they handed the keys, you know, to Brock Purdy. So, you know, sometimes you just don't know. You just don't know. And that's that's what it means to be, you know, best player available. Shanahan sure know how to, you know, get quarterback. But Jared Goff validate this year, bro. I mean, got to pay him. That's how I look at it. You got to pay him. Unless you come in with a hot shot prospect. Now, if you're able to get Bryce Young, I mean, hey, I think he's going number one, they saying. You know, that's what I heard. You sound like he's going number one. I can't argue with that. I mean, I think he is the number one quarterback. You know, if somebody younger come in and beat him out, so be it. But I think at the quarterback position, I think you got to be prepared, especially if you got a team that feel like you can win now. And San Francisco and New England have been the platinum standards at that. You know, I think Philadelphia kind of been right behind them with Hurts and Carson Wentz and all that. You got to be prepared. You know, Nick Foles, Carson Wentz, you got to be prepared. You have to be prepared. So, but yeah, next year is, you know, if he ball out next year, pull up similar numbers or greater numbers. I just think you at the point where, you know, got to crown him. So, check out Detroit Lions Talk playlist. Thumbs up the video, share the video, subscribe to the channel. Next subscribe button is the bell icon button. Hit all notifications, increase your chance, get notifications. We go live or drop a video. Check out Detroit Lions Talk playlist for more videos like this. Appreciate the love and support. Everybody showing the channel. Appreciate y'all. Hit the link tree. You can find me everywhere. Peace.